Hello dear friends, today we'll start with the next topic of under heading corrosion, that is weight corrosion or electrochemical corrosion. In the last video we have seen dry corrosion, its mechanism, peeling Bedworth rule and related topic. Okay, now go to this part, weight corrosion and mechanism of weight corrosion. This weight corrosion is also called as electrochemical corrosion. The name itself indicates what is meaning of weight corrosion. For such type of corrosion, weight conditions are required. Some solution is required. Some medium is required. Water may be required or moisture may be work as conducting medium. Or it is also called as electrochemical corrosion. Like a electrochemical cell, one part of the corrosion cell will work as anode part, it will undergo oxidation, one part will work as a cathode part, it will undergo reduction. So it is a sort of redox type of reaction called weight corrosion or electrochemical corrosion. How this corrosion occur? It occur by existence of, by formation of separate anode and cathode part in presence of the conducting solution. Okay, through which current flows. So there will be separate anode and cathode part. So one is anode part, and we know that anode part will always undergo oxidation. Oxidation, isn't it? And if this is my metal exposed to the conducting medium, this is my divalent metal as we are taking it. If this is a divalent metal, okay, it is going to form meta ions, two positive and with a loss of two electrons. This is an oxidation reaction of metal. Who will work as a anode part of the cell, right? What happens to this? What happened to the metal ions? These metal ions form on oxidation reaction at anode part. Either they get dissolved in the medium, that is a dissolution process or a sort of decay process, or these metal ions may form compounds. They may form compounds like hydroxides, oxides, okay, or maybe sulfates, yeah, maybe nitrates and so on, right, like this. So this is a reaction. What happens to cathode part? So this is anode reaction, cathode reaction. And we also know that anode part of the cell, anode part of any cell, any battery, always put to loss, always undergo corrosion here, yeah, decay and destruction. Cathode part never put to loss. Cathode part of the cell always get protected. And every time cathode reaction is reduction reaction. Then what? And reduction is, you know that it is a gain of electron. Now, let us make one point clear that also I have given in my PPTs. What is that? For this type of corrosion, though two different anode and cathode are required, but not necessarily two different metals like copper and zinc, like iron and magnesium. Means two different metals may not be required like these every time I am exposed to the medium. This will work as anode, this will work as cathode. This may not be required. If this is there, same corrosion is there, but number of times same part of metal. See, this is metal suppose, not same part. This is a metal, okay? Yeah, metal rods, yeah, metal bars. Like last time I gave the example, metal bars fixed in the windows. Okay, so these are the iron bars suppose. So the one metal rod, either these or these suppose, yeah, any one metal rod, different part of the same metal, different areas of the same metal rod, yeah, same metal sheet, yeah, same metal structure may work as, work in a different manner. One part may work as a anode part, one part may work as a cathode part. Getting it? What is the example? These are the iron bars, suppose fixed in a windows,
then some dust particles may accumulate here, some sand particles may accumulate here, or any type of impurity may form on the exposed part of metal. And this is medium. So because of this sort of impurity or because of this sort of coating, the medium directly cannot attack on this part. The medium may not attack on this underlying part, but the same medium can attack on this part, can attack on this exposed part, may attack on this exposed part. Let us consider medium is water, yeah, moisture along with oxygen, atmospheric oxygen. In that case, this much part, this portion of metal behave differently. This part will behave different manner. Similarly, this portion is experiencing different medium. This will be not attacked by the medium, and so on. So same metal rod, one metal structure behave in different manner. One part will work as cathode, anode part. One part will work as cathode part. Like here, this part exposed to medium, yeah, medium directly attack on the open part of the metal will work as anode part. This will work as anode part. This will work as a cathode part. Sorry, anode part. This portion, where on this part of the metal, direct attack of the medium may not be possible. So it will behave differently. It will behave as a cathode. Getting it? So either this kind of situation exposed to so and so medium, or different parts of the same metal, one metal, behave differently. Under that condition also, this type of corrosion occur, isn't it? So let us make this part clear. Anode cathode means not two different metal every time. It may be this kind of situation, isn't it? Okay. Now suppose this kind of situation we are explaining. In that case, what happens? The metal has a tendency to undergo oxidation. It will undergo oxidation. Same metal cannot get reduced at the same time. Means either I am going out of the class or I am coming in. I am going out means I am losing. I am coming in means I am gaining. Gain of electron. So one element at a time cannot show both the reaction. Then what is the reaction at cathode? It is always reduction. So what is that reduction reaction? These electrons release by anode reaction. It will go to the cathode part. At the cathode part, medium will accept the electrons. Medium accept the electrons coming from the cathode. Isn't it? We'll see that reactions afterwards. And accordingly, it will form hydroxides or oxides or sulfates or carbonates or nitrates or some other ions, negative ions. Right? And metal ions form at anode, these ions form at cathode, they will diffuse towards each other, they will move towards each other, and somewhere between anode and cathode, it may form rust products as metal oxide, yeah, metal hydroxide, yeah, metal sulfate, and so on. These kind of reactions are there in wet corrosion. I repeat, in wet corrosion, one part, like this kind of situation we try to explain, one metal sheet. So one part of the metal will work as anode, one part will work as cathode, another part will work as anode, next part will work as cathode, and so on. Under that case, so many tiny cells get formed. Anode reaction, loss of electrons, electrons will go from anode to cathode. At cathode, medium will accept the electrons, they will form such type of anions, yeah, negatively charged ions. So finally, these positively charged ions form at anode and negatively charged ions form at cathode. They will travel towards each other, and somewhere in between anode and cathode, it will form a rust product. Metal hydroxide may be rust, or it may be metal oxide as a rust product. These type of reactions observed in a electrochemical reaction, yeah, in a wet corrosion. I hope you are getting these points. They are very basic points. Actually, in our syllabus, we have only mechanism. We should be able to write mechanisms of wet corrosion under a different medium. means what are the anode and cathode reaction under different electrolyte, under different conditions of medium. That is our topic. Anyway, now important reaction in the corrosion is oxidation reaction. Oxidation reaction. As I said last time, if this is my metal structure, if this is my metal rod and it is undergoing oxidation, if it is made of 1000 particles, in one reaction one particle is lost, in second reaction second particle is lost. Simplest example, if my head or my skull is anode and my hairs are the ions, that anode is made of 1000 hairs, so in one reaction I am losing one hair, in second reaction I am losing second hair. That loss is oxidation reaction. So corrosion always occur at anode part of the cell where oxidation reaction is observed. That has to be properly mentioned. So this is an important reaction. Okay, now if this is a reaction, metal as usual divalent, so it is forming m2 plus plus 2 electron. So for removal of electron or by forming ions, certain amount of energy is required, right? That is, to remove my hair, some different energy required. To remove somebody's hair, some different energy required, and so on. That is changing from metal to metal, isn't it? And that idea of the elements to undergo oxidation reaction, that is at what rate the particular element is undergoing oxidation reaction, forming ions by loss of electrons or losing ion by forming ions, can be explained or is given by the term called as electrode potential. Electrode potential. I repeat, the important reaction in corrosion is a reaction taking place at anode. That is oxidation reaction. This is that oxidation reaction, isn't it? And that for removal of electrons by giving ions means to undergo oxidation for any element or for any metal, certain amount of energy is required, and that is found to be different for different metals, elements, right? That's why elements shows different corrosion tendency. For example, if you take case of lithium, at what rate it is undergoing oxidation? That rate is found to be very high. It fastly undergo oxidation reaction. If you take case of magnesium, comparatively it has a good tendency but lesser than lithium. If you take case of zinc, it has also good tendency to undergo oxidation but lesser than magnesium. If you compare that with copper, it shows very, very minimum tendency to undergo oxidation. Rather, it shows tendency to undergo reduction. Instead of losing electron, it prefers to gain electron. So metal behaves in different manner. And how they behave, that information can be obtained from this term, that is called as electrode potential. Electrode potential value. It is also called as standard electrode potential, that is SEP, measured in volts at room temperature, at 25 degree centigrade. So before going to mechanism, let us have some brief idea about what is electrode potential and how it is measured, isn't it? What is electrode potential? Now all the metals, almost all the metals, shows tendency to pass in the solution as metal ions by giving electrons. Meaning is that if you have a solution, if you have aqueous solution, if you have water, and if you dip a metal like this, metal is immersed, suppose zinc is immersed, right? Then it has tendency, this zinc has a tendency to pass in the solution, means some of the zinc atoms, some of the zinc atoms will shed their, will go in the solution as zinc ions, and electrons will be held on the metal like this. So there will be formation of sort of electrical double layer, and when the balance get disturbed, it result in the formation of potential difference between the solution and the metal. So basically, in one line, the tendency of metal to go in the solution as metal ions by giving electrons is measured in terms of electrode potential. isn't it?